All right, so here we are. This is the end of the game. All right, it's the last level before you go up to the Sky Fortress and get Ravenbeak. Right now we're at 4 hours 18 minutes. So basically, if we finish the game right now, we'd be done in 4.5 hours. But we're going for 100% completion, which means going back through all the levels and getting all the pickups that we didn't get before because we couldn't. It takes about 2 hours. In post-production, I'm not going to sit here and talk for 2 hours while I do cleanup. I'm just going to, you know, show myself, get in the extra, you know, the missiles, the power bombs, the energy parts, the energy tanks. That's it. Here and there I might talk, you know, comment on what's going on. But for right now, you can go beat this game right now. You have plenty of missiles. You don't need a whole bunch of power bombs. You have plenty of energy. So there you go. All right. And this is my sequence for cleanup. Where is it? I gotta find it. It's in my notes. Okay. This is the way I the best way I could find. All right, so we go back to Gabber, and we use the orange teleporter that takes us back to Cataris. From there, we use the red teleporter to go back to Artaria. Clean up Artaria, go to Cataris without using a teleportal. Clean up Cataris, use the purple teleportal to go to Dairin. Clean up Dairin. Don't use a teleportal, go to Gavarin. Clean up there. From Gavarin, go back down to Berenia, clean that up, and then use, in Berenia, there's a blue teleportal we haven't used. That takes us to Ferenia, clean up Ferenia, and then go back to Gavarin, double back to Alun, get the few things in there's like two things in Alun, and then from there, back here to Hanabia, and then endgame. So, here we go. It doesn't always go according to plan. I say that like, you know, but then I end up on, I'll be in like Cataris and the red teleporter will be halfway across the screen or something, you know. Fortunately, we got most of the, I would say, the hard shine sparks. Difficult. There's like one or two left. Flickering light. Metroid Dread 2. Go throughout. Well, it's too late. Because, well, no, it's not really a spoiler. You blow up the damn planet. But that's a good topic. What is Metroid Dread 2 gonna be? All right. So for Gavarin, I'll do a walkthrough of Gavarin 100%. But what is going to be the... excuse me. What is the next Metroid game going to be? Ostensibly, it should be Prime 4. And I talked about that. What is Prime 4 going to look like on a Switch? What are the controls going to be like? Very, very curious about that. Is it this one? No. So, when you're doing cleanup, this is a great feature. You just highlight missiles, and then, alright, so I'm missing 5 missiles in Gavarin. And there's a power bomb there, and there's some hidden items here, here, and here. So I'm at 33%. So this should take about, hopefully about 15 minutes. But ultimately, we want to end up back up here so we can go to Cataris. So let's start at the bottom and work our way up. Hey. Once again, a good thing to do when doing cleanup, because you're done with bosses and enemies and all that shit, get an audiobook or a podcast and just sort of dig in with one of those. I have to think here for a second. You know, give yourself something to, you know, bide your time. Call an old friend. I don't know. Call your mother. If you can call your mother. Nope. I'm already fucking this up. Certainly don't listen to this soundtrack because it's nothing enjoyable about it. Ah, mother. Ah, bastards. Getting the timing on cross bombs is really hard. There we go. Kinda have to get out a little in front of it. Alright. I end up taking notes. I take notes of what I want to do in the game, and then I sit here and I'm like, wait a minute, what am I supposed to do? Because I take such bad notes. Access open. Alright. There. 53%. Not bad. Not missing anything up there. I'm sure it has another name other than Big Fucking Crab. Ow. Come here. Don't do that. See, I just want the ice beam. This is fucking bullshit. Fire. Fire. Get our energy parts. Go back down. We'll get this on the way out. Actually, should I get it now? No, no, no. We'll get it on the way out. Right now. Okay, blinking white area. I don't know what that is. Oh, I got it. Cool. All right, a little shine spark there. Kill Pudgy the Whale. We gotta go all the way down here. There's no shortcuts. Ta-da. This little area that we skipped, because at the time it's just, you don't have space jump, all you have is grapple beam, and I don't do well with grapple beam, especially if the Tarzan the shit out of it. By Tarzan the shit out of it, I mean like, go from point to point. Other M, I can do it. Metroid Prime, I can do it. Can't do it here, I don't know why. Shut up. Alright, did I miss anything up here? I don't think so. I'm at 73%. That's good. Go down here, go get that. So. So we fought that stupid son of a bitch. Goes a soldier. And you're never gonna need an energy refill ever. Because you're just constantly screw attacking enemies to get the shit, and you're not really facing enough enemies to do enough damage. Fudgy the Whale there. 80%. That's not good. No. Check your map. I wonder if they're gonna release the old Metroid games on the eShop. I don't see why they wouldn't, you know? People are gonna pay money for them. I would. If Fusion came out right now on the eShop, I'd buy it. Because it would look better than playing it on Game Boy Player. Wait, what am I doing here? Oh, I think I'm thinking Ferenia right now. That's stupid. There we go. All my Metroid games run together. 86%. What am I missing? Oh, that one. Whoa. And well, there's only one way we can go, it's this way. Russell Sprout. This one's easy. <clears throat> 93%. So all we have to do is get that power bomb and we're at 100%. Getting there is kind of a bitch. I think I'll go this way. There's another game that can be kind of fun, like play as an Emmy trying to kill Santa. Oops. Get out of my way, Enki. Get out of my way. Alright. There you go, 100%. Now you just gotta do it. 6 more times. son of a bitch. I think my last playthrough, for some reason I just decided, oh, I'm not gonna get the pulse radar, and that door was closed, so I couldn't go to Cataris. So there you go, clean up right now and gather in about 15 minutes. That's good. Clean up in every area should be about 15 minutes. So I'm going to leave you here. And we'll see you at the end. Or some parts in the middle. Damn it. Where'd he go? Ah, fuck. Thank you. Alright, here comes the fun shine spark. Fun. All right, that's 100%. Head on down to Graver and go and meet some friends of mine. Nearly had a heart attack. I was like, oh my god, I'm not recording. Don't turn it off. I would make a stupid knucklehead mistake like that too. Just end up all the way back at fucking Hanuvia with 100% nothing to show for it. What is it, like, one missile tank and an energy tank? Stupid like that? I don't know why I thought that was energy. not missing anything in Hanubia. Hanubia. So I completely forgot to clean up Arteria. Hello, sports fans. I completely forgot to clean up Arteria. I don't know how the fuck I did that, but I... epic fail. I got all the way to Hanubia, and I'm like, wait a minute, why am I only at 90%? And I realized, oh shit, I didn't do anything in Arteria. I totally spaced this. So I thought I was gonna have a good end time, but now that's kind of screwed. At the end of the day, it doesn't matter. It's not like I'm curing cancer. I'm just playing Metroid. Ah, fuck. Every Metroid game seems to have that one room that's like a really long and has lava, and at the end there's just one missile tank. I don't know how that works. Oh shit, there it is. Fuck. Good. Oh.